Careful here, boys. Sheet ice.
We're driving to the summit of this mountain so we can park up next to the ice restaurant and go into the Elements James Bond exhibition next door.
Solden, Austria. To add to what Charlie was saying, we've just vetoed the gondola saving us 20 euros each as we've seen a single track road that runs up the mountain that we can drive the hire car up. Little did we know that this single track road was only used by service vehicles, disabled access to the midway restaurant, and mainly...
hikers.
Cowards!
Whose idea was this?
Tom's. All of like the fitness freaks were like giving us evils, hands on hips.
Snobby.
As we're the only car driving up the single track road. We were parked where we could, and now we're walking up the mountain on this track to prove all these snobs wrong.
Only like another 1,000 meters of elevation to go.
My name is Tom Bessett, and I cut corners.
Rally on, mate.
2 hours later.
Single moan. No moaning.
Zero moaning.
We don't moan.
Charlie's come up in pink shoes.
Lovely.
What are those?
Ralph Lauren.
Ralph Lauren.
Polo Sport.
Three booze hounds just staggering up the hill, ill prepared. 1 litre of water.
Ralph Lauren. 1,000 metres elevation.
Chilly in there, wasn't it, Tom?
The aircon. It was unbelievable.
I'm only a little Ralph Lauren.
This seems to take a minute. Thank you.
You're not coming over here, mate.
What are you doing?
I just felt you.
That's quite good.
We're trying to do the next big challenge, which is can we sneak on the gondola without paying? Are we allowed down? Or are we going to have to walk all the way back down?
We're going to bribe the gondola man.
This is the
deciding moment.
This is
the
fucking hell. I almost.
How was your trip, Nick?
It's 20 too much.
We've got this.
Come on, lads.
Brexit bribery.
Come on.
We can do this. You're straight on it, man.
We walked up.
We hiked it. Yeah, it was hard, man.
Then you have to buy tickets on the middle station.
Okay. Now I'm feeling so fly,
like a G6. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames grew higher, and it burned, burned, burned. The ring of fire, the ring of fire.
There's the car.
These guys are waiting for us.
Who's fired?
Our friend Joe was supposed to come with us on the trip, but ended up bailing last minute.
Joe! Joe? Joe, we're getting a photo!
Have you seen him the whole trip? He's disappearing.
He must have,
mate. He's one elusive character.
I definitely saw him getting on the flight. Or maybe I didn't.
I sat next to him.
Did you?
Yeah, man.
You're sure that wasn't another
I shared
guy?
My nuts.
Anyone watching this are just.
Brilliant.
Stunt it!
3, 2, 1.
Yes! Rock and fucking roll!
Let's get out, let's get out!
Got this.
Come on, Charlie!
Charlie, come in! Yeah. Charlie, come in! Come on, Charlie!
Joe, mate.
Joe, your dinner's getting cold, mate.
About to go on water cannon.
Guinea pig.
Don't take the piss, like, I'm fucking doing it.
No, mate, you don't want to do that.
I'm not nervous yet.
When the pressure gauge goes, that's when I'm going to start freaking. What am I doing? What?
Got me that one.
You went so far! Where'd you find those sunglasses, eh, Tom?
In my bag.
Pretty cool, aren't they? Nice leopard print.
Yeah, right.
Where'd you find those sunglasses, Tom?
Jump out, yeah?
Yeah. 3, 2, 1, go! Yep. 3, 2, 1, go!
1, 2, break!
Gonna get a job here then, eh?
Joe?
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 Joe? Back slapper. Told you it was gonna be back slapper.
I feel pretty good, man.
Saturday night, Club Area 47. 350 people, a fast EDM DJ, custom Harley mounted above, and overlooking the club is a painting of the park's founder, none other than Jimmy Savile himself. No, that's not Jimmy Savile. Two dancers' cages sit either side of the DJ, seemingly not accessible to the public. 20 minutes before closing, Tom turns to me and he goes, "Mate, you should get in one of those cages." "How are we gonna do it then, mate?" Under the left-hand cage sits a bouncer, so we make our way to the other side of the club. Well, it's now or never, isn't it? Charlie and Tom hoist me up to where I can grab this ledge of floorboards sticking out from the balcony above, pull myself up onto this ledge until I'm standing on it. Now, by this point, the crowd has realized what was going on. Out come flashlights as you see they start filming. I start shimmying across this ledge, work my way around the speaker, and then jump down into the cage. And then, well, there's a video, isn't there? If you listen closer, you can actually hear the point that it makes Tom's year. Three bouncers come to my side, separated by a netting in between. Now they're screaming at me in Austrian. I don't speak Austrian, but I imagine it was something along the lines of, "Get the fuck out of the cage. What do you want me to do?" They couldn't get to me, neither did I want to get down. Then I get this overwhelming sinking feeling. I'd seen a fight earlier in the night where this guy had run up to this other guy sitting down and toe punted him in the ribs and jumps up, flailing. Mayhem ensues. And I was thinking, are these three bouncers gonna take me out to this car park and beat me down? Oh well, might as well enjoy the rest of it. Then I realize it's actually me sinking. I'm going down. I look out over the edge of the cage, where the DJ's got his hand on the missile control switch for the cage hydraulics. Needless to say, he did not look impressed. this point, all the staff are rushing the booth, even the glass collector. What the fuck was he gonna do? A bouncer instantly takes my arm and frog marches me past the DJ. I'm smiling, feet accomplished. Good set, man. No reply. But he didn't look anywhere near as upset as he did earlier. I think he was just trying to work out how I got up in there. It wasn't until the strobe came on that he clocked you, man. Marched down the stairs and out through a fire escape into the car park. Bouncer turns to me and he says, "Your night's over." What the fuck is that supposed to mean? And nothing. Scot-free, the end. Charlie and Bessett come and join me out the main entrance and say they've been watching me like hawks. They were going to break up any violence that ensued. Tom's words were even, "Mate, if you were going to get beaten up, I was going to get beaten up."
We have 6 kilometres of fuel left.
6.3 kilometres.
This is called efficiency.
Oh, this is where I had an accident with a bottle while playing cowbell for a 1700 sellout disco night in a church. We pick up this story in Munich. Gonna just do some vlogging, mate.
Joe!
Milthorpe!
He's just gonna get around it.
Well then, Tom, you just made the video.
Hey.
What are you filming?
No.